Astronomers have found a super-fast star system that appears to break the models that are currently used in physics. Thousands of light-years away, on the fringes of the Milky Way, astronomers have discovered something that no one has ever seen before. A binary star, two stars orbiting a common center of mass that is moving so quickly that it has clock speeds that almost rival the escape velocity of our galaxy. This is the first time a binary star of this type has ever been discovered, but what exactly is it? Is it something related to another civilization? Hey viewers, welcome back to the Future Space. In today's video, we are going to observe a mysterious galaxy that breaks every single law of current physics. What do you think it will be? Do let us know your assumptions in the comment below. And stay with us till the end of this video so you don't miss out on any of this information. But before we proceed, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell symbol so that you don't miss out on any of our wonderful videos in the future. And let's get started. What exactly does that entail? Something must be helping this star system gather such incredible momentum, and up until this point, the best explanation we had for hypervelocity stars was that they were being propelled by the supermassive black holes that lurk at the center of a galaxy. However, recent research has shown that this may not be the case. The problem, however, is that the binary star is not even remotely close to a supermassive black hole. This binary star, which we've given the designation PB3877 and which is found approximately 18,000 light-years away from Earth, is not the first hypervelocity star that we've discovered in our galaxy. More than 20 hypervelocity stars that appear to be hell-bent on escaping our cosmic neighborhood have been identified by astronomers so far. US-708 is an example of this type of hypervelocity star. Its speed through the Milky Way was measured at approximately 745 miles per second in 2005. This is equivalent to 1,198 kilometers per second, which is equivalent to 2.7 million miles per hour. This is fast enough to break free from the gravitational pull of the galaxy. One of the researchers who discovered US-708, Eugene Magnier, from the University of Hawaii, stated that if one were to travel at that speed, it would take only 5 minutes to get from Earth to the Moon. In approximately 25 million years, the US-708 starship is forecast to exit the Milky Way galaxy. However, all of the other hypervelocity stars that we have discovered up until this point have been solitary stars. Astronomers have made history by discovering a binary star system that travels at a speed faster than light for the first time. Ulrich Heber, a researcher at Friedrich Alexander University in Germany and one of the people responsible for the discovery, said, "We studied hypervelocity stars since 2005, the year of discovery of the first three. In the meantime, about 24 have been found, but none of them are companions. None of them have a companion directly visible in their spectrum." Another thing that distinguishes PB3877 from anything else that astronomers have discovered is the fact that it is moving along the outskirts of the Milky Way. All of the other hypervelocity stars that we are aware of have been located in relative close proximity to the supermassive black hole that sits at the center of our galaxy, and physicists have generally agreed that this is the only way in which their incredible acceleration rates can be explained. Now, we have something that seriously calls into question the validity of this hypothesis. In 2011, researchers made the initial discovery of PB3877 by using data from the Sloan Digital Sky Survey, but at the time, they believed it to be a single star. Now, thanks to new observations made with the 10-meter Keck 2 telescope in Hawaii and the 8.2-meter Very Large Telescope in Chile, the team in Germany has been able to confirm that it was both a hypervelocity star and a binary system. These new observations were made possible by the Very Large Telescope in Chile. It appears to be composed of one super-hot star that is more than 5 times hotter than our Sun, as well as a companion that is 1,000 degrees cooler than our Sun. When we looked at the new data, much to our surprise, we found weak absorption lines that could not come from the hot star, says Thomas Kupfer, an astronomer from the California Institute of Technology. These lines could not have been produced by the hot star. The radial velocity of the cool companion is high, just like the radial velocity of the hot primary. As a result, the two stars combine to form a binary system, which is the very first candidate for a hypervelocity wide binary. They were also successful in tracing its path, which led them to the conclusion that the object could not have come from the center of the Milky Way. This indicates that it was not propelled in its current direction by a supermassive black hole. According to one of the researchers on the team, Eva Ziegler, "From our calculations, we can rule out the galactic center as the place of origin due to the fact that its trajectory never came close to it. Other ejection mechanisms, such as stellar collisions and the explosion of a supernova, have been proposed. However, all of these mechanisms would result in the breakdown of a wide binary. Instead, the team hypothesizes that either a crapload of dark matter must be surrounding the star like a kind of halo to keep it stable at such incredible speeds at the edge of the galaxy, or that PB3877 could be an intergalactic intruder formed in a neighboring galaxy before infiltrating ours. It is not known for certain whether it will ever travel beyond the Milky Way in the future. In order to calculate the probability that the star will in fact continue to be bound to the galaxy, we made use of a variety of models of mass. This is only the case for the model of the galaxy with the greatest mass. Andreas Ergong, who works at Dr. Carl Remus Observatory in Germany, is one of the researchers who commented on the findings. Because of this, PB3877 is an excellent choice for use as a target to investigate dark matter halo models. The findings have been published in the Astrophysical Journal Letters, and according to the team, the mere existence of this binary system puts pressure on accepted models and our current understanding of dark matter in the Milky Way. Instead of a black hole, the Milky Way could have a core of dark matter. The current scientific consensus holds that our galaxy is home to a supermassive black hole. We know this is true in other galaxies. In M87, there is even photographic evidence of a black hole. A new study, however, suggests that the Milky Way may not have a black hole. Based on the properties of several objects seen zipping around it, the object known as Sagittarius A could be a blob of dark matter. If true, this would have far-reaching consequences for our understanding of the universe. The issue is that we can't see Sagittarius A star directly, as one might expect from a black hole. We can only infer its presence from the movement of objects in its vicinity, which appear to be under the influence of a massive object. Previously, scientists used the motion of objects such as the star S2 to validate general relativity as they pass through the alleged black hole. But then there's G2. This object, which could or could not be a cloud of hydrogen gas, flew by Sagittarius A star a while ago and wasn't torn apart as expected. Last year, a group of Italian researchers demonstrated that the movement of S2 and G2 was also consistent with a different model, one in which dark matter fermions inhabitate the center of the Milky Way. Because these particles are so light, they would not collide into a black hole until there were 100 times more of them. At the same time, they could congregate in a dark blob and exert gravity on nearby objects. The new study, published in M.N. Ra's Letters, extended that model to the 17 best characterized S-group stars orbiting the galactic center. And indeed, these orbits are compatible with a bubble of dark matter in Sagittarius A star rather than a black hole. Scientists currently estimate that the visible part of the universe accounts for only about 20% of its total mass. The rest is dark matter, which we have yet to properly characterize. We can only infer the presence of dark matter, like black holes, from gravitational effects. This research could imply that the two phenomena are linked. According to the researchers, these clumps of dark matter can reach critical mass and collapse into black holes. That could help to explain how these enormous supermassive objects came to be in the first place, which we have only speculated on. At the same time, this could explain a large portion of the universe's missing mass. However, none of this is certain. There could be other explanations, or this group's analysis could be incorrect. We won't know until scientists have spent a significant amount of time staring at this region of space. And that's it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed the video. If so, please click on the like button and share it with your friends and family. If you have any questions or comments, please share them with us in the comment space below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more of our incredible videos. You can also check out our other videos that have been specially selected for you. We'll catch up in the next video. Thank you so much for watching.